Okay, so for quiz 4, question 3. In many colleges and universities around the country, educators are changing their approach to instruction from a teacher-lecture-centered model to a student-centered model, where students learn in a laboratory environment in which lecture is de-emphasized and students can proceed at a pace suitable to their learning needs. In one school where this model is being introduced, of the 743 students who enrolled in the traditional lecture model, 364 of them passed. Of the 567 in the student-centered model, 335 passed. Does the evidence suggest that the student-centered model results in a higher pass rate than the traditional model and will be using the 0.05 level of significance? Now, we first have to verify the requirements to perform the hypothesis test. First, we can reasonably assume that each sample is a simple random sample. Now, the second part, we have the sample of the teacher-centered model, 364 of them passed, out of the population of the student-centered model being 743. Now, we have the same for the student-centered model, sample being 335 out of a population of 567. Now, to find our sample proportion here, we simply divide 364 by 743 to get 0.490, and then to verify our model, we simply multiply the population by the sample proportion multiplied by 1 minus 0.49, which would get us 185.7, which is greater than or equal to 10. For the student sample proportion, we would do the same thing, being the sample 335 divided by the population to get 0.591, which we would again multiply the population by the sample proportion multiplied by 1 minus the sample proportion to get 137.1, which is greater than or equal to 10. And finally, each sample is considered to be less than 5% of the population, so the requirements are met and we can conduct the test. So next we would write our hypotheses. For our null hypothesis, we would write that the population, the proportion of teacher is equal to teacher-centered model is equal to the proportion of student-centered model, while the alternative hypothesis is that the proportion of teacher-centered model is less than the proportion of student-centered model. And of course, we will be using, as said, the 0.05 level of significance. And we would also need to have a pooled estimate of the proportion. So what we would simply do is add together the samples of the two models and divide them by the sum of the two populations to get 0.534. Now for our test statistic, since we have the data, we would simply substitute it in with 0.490 being our proportion for the sample proportion for the teachers, minus the sample proportion for the students, 0.591. And then we would also substitute 0.534 being our pooled estimate, times 1 minus 0.5, again the pooled estimate, square rooted the entire equation, multiplied by 1 over the population of the teacher-centered model, added to 1 over the student-centered model, the entire thing square rooted, and plugged it into a calculator, we would get negative 3.59. And using the p-value approach to find our p-value, we would simply find the probability of our z-statistic being less than or equal to negative 3.59, being the probability of that being less than 0.002. And since our p-value is less than the level of significance being 0.05, we would reject the null hypothesis. So we would reject the null hypothesis. So, to conclude, that would mean that there is sufficient evidence at the level of significance of 0.05 to conclude that the proportion of students who will pass the class is lower with traditional lecture-based instruction than student-centered instruction.